And now, Rob on the Road, exploring Northern California.
When you think of planetary sciences and astronomy, Placerville may not be the first spot that comes to mind. But since it opened in 2006, the Community Observatory has been providing free public access to explore the cosmos. Let's take an up-close look into the sky and meet some of the docents who volunteer their time to guide space explorers of all ages.
It is one of Northern California's fascinating gems, and it's right here in our own backyard. It's the Community Observatory of Placerville, where you get a window to the entire universe. This is Gordon Dolfie. He's the lead docent here. Gordon, good to see you.
Nice to see you, Rob. Welcome.
I'm glad to be here. This is so exciting.
Yeah, we're going to see some neat stuff tonight.
Okay, so first of all, where are we? What are we surrounded with besides telescopes?
Well, we've got a whole room here that's dedicated to looking at the night sky. This is where we are open every weekend, year round. And this is where we show people the wonders of the universe.
This has been a place where, as we talk about 100,000 people coming through here, you must see some really amazing moments on people's faces.
All the time, and that's one of the joys of being a docent here at the observatory. We have about 40-ish of really dedicated people that are volunteers, that are docents here, and there's not a night that goes by or a day when we're doing solar viewing when people who haven't looked through a telescope before don't gasp or shout out or say something like, wow, I never even knew what was visible.
One of those docents is Elizabeth Gabler, who guided me on my very first solar viewing.
All right, this is your scope.
Yeah, so this is a white light telescope. So what it takes is it filters out 99.9% of the light, so you just see the lower atmosphere of the sun.
Okay.
You wanna take a look at it?
This scope looks really cool. We're looking straight into the sun.
Mm-hmm.
I didn't even know that was possible.
You'll notice it's a little bit more white than what we're seeing through the atmosphere.
Okay, the true color of the sun. Oh my gosh. I thought it would be yellow or orange, but it's white.
The yellow you see is from our atmosphere. So if you were in space looking at the sun, this would be its true color.
Wow. And looking at the sun, I am 40 something years old and I've never looked straight at the sun. It's absolutely beautiful. How cool! Thank you!
You're welcome.
Very cool.
Next, docent Pat Graheck invites me to look through a different telescope to see spectacular solar prominences comprised of electrically charged plasma looping from the surface of the sun hundreds of thousands of miles into space and back. Seeing this is breathtaking.
I see it. Oh my gosh, it's like a fire that looks like a ginkgo leaf.
Right.
It's so pretty.
Yes, you're looking at the sun. 93 million miles away.
93 million. And it takes eight minutes.
For the light to reach your hand.
Unbelievable.
That's how far it is.
8 minutes, wow.
I asked docent Forrest Lockhart to show me the latest addition to the Community Observatory.
What do we have here?
This is our imaging observatory.
Imaging observatory.
It's brand new. It was dedicated just last month. It was 6 years in the making. And it's something very special because this is not for public use.
Oh, it's not.
This is going to be dedicated for high school students and community college students.
The Community Observatory welcomes academic project applications from local high schools and colleges each year. Selected applicants are granted the opportunity to conduct research and even publish reports in a professional setting.
You're probably one of a dozen people who've been in there so far.
Well, let's do it.
Let's do it.
Can we? All right. Just opened up like that.
This gives you a full 360 degree view of it.
Wow.
This telescope is very unique.
Mm-hmm.
It's strictly an imaging telescope.
That means this telescope will give students a private lens to take their own images and use them in actual studies alongside fellow astronomers.
The sun and the moon are so spectacular, and I love how all of it is celebrated here and that you can get so close to our galaxy.
That's right. Through the different telescopes we have, we look at objects that are both close by, like the moon, that's the closest one we look at, and we can look at objects that are as far away as other galaxies that are very far away.
I've been to planetariums and seen things right. like that, but this lets you really be involved with the solar system. I mean, you can come right up to it and have an intimate look.
No, I think that's a good point. It's not just about coming and then being quickly moved through here and looking through the telescopes. We try to engage people for the whole 2 hours that we're open each night. And we do it both through having them look through the telescopes, but also we have other docents that can stand around and explain what they're looking at and actually give them tours of the sky in our amphitheater outside.
Wow, that's fantastic. This is such a unique space. I've been doing this show for 10 years, and this is one of the most unique things I have found.
I think, you know, if you want to escape kind of the day-to-day and all the different troubles and turmoils, come here and you'll really be transported to a different place where you can get a better appreciation for where we fit into the bigger scheme of things.
It's pretty cool.
Right. So if anybody's interested in coming to our nighttime programs, it's every Friday, Saturday, and Sunday night. From 7:30 to 9:30 during the winter, and from 8:30 to 10:30 during the summer.
Now your community events are fun, and they are packed, and people show up, and it's like a tailgating and telescope party.
It is.
You know, it's a lot of fun.